Well, this is quite amazing. As we were talking about how to structure this event, a lot of my wiser colleagues said, if you give people a break in the middle, they'll disappear. But I think it's a tribute to the quality of the discussion and really, frankly, the charisma of this group of people that you stayed on. This is Sunday afternoon, and we're getting down towards the end. We had kind of a special announcement that I'd like to kind of go through with you. We are at the point now where we are going to create a new think tank here in Tokyo. It's going to focus on internet policy issues. The name is going to be the Asia Pacific Institute for a Digital Economy. And it's going to be working with 45 major research universities throughout the Asia Pacific region. As you know, we got started about 4 years ago as a research group here at KO, and we're going to continue to remain closely affiliated with the university. But we hope that the new status that we have, we're going to be registering as an NPO, is going to give us the flexibility that we need to engage with stakeholders both in and outside the academic community. We believe, and I think one of the reasons that I wanted to key and link this particular event with announcing the new think tank, which really is going to be, I think, the first of its kind, not just in Japan, but in the Asia region, is we believe that universities have a special responsibility to be very active, proactive in this debate. As you can see, individual researchers and universities played a huge role in creation of the internet, the developing of all the engineering and other requirements necessary to get this thing up and running. But I think as Dave has helped us to better understand, the softer part of the internet, the policy aspects of the internet, are really, in some respects, what are holding us back. The internet has jumped out of the laboratories and into the real world. And as it's become increasingly embedded in the real world, we have a lot of problems that are associated with it. Now, the internet is not going to solve those problems, but I think the internet needs at some level to be protected, and at other levels needs to be empowered so we can begin to address some of those problems. So that's the kind of thing that, that we would like to focus on. We are very, very fortunate in doing this that we've been able to attract an outstanding board of people drawn from many, many different aspects of Japan. Japanese industry and business, from the legal profession, engineering community, academia, and the U.S. business community in Tokyo, to work as our board. I'd like to announce briefly the names of the members of the board. A number of them are with us here tonight, and in a short while, I'll ask them to just give a few words. Masanobu Kato is the Executive Vice President and Executive Director and Country Head for Intellectual Ventures. He will be acting as the chairman of our board. Ko Fuji is not here with us tonight, but he's the CEO of Makaira, which is a consulting firm here in Tokyo. Crystal Fleur is a senior advisor with McClarty Associates. He's also the chairman of the American Chamber of Commerce in Japan. Akinori Maimura is not with us tonight. He's actually off in Brazil at the Global Internet Governance Forum. He's the general manager for internet development with JPMIC, Japan Information Network Center. Naoko Mizukoshi is here. She is an attorney with Endeavor, an independent law office, and is a specialist in intellectual property. Yoshihiro Obata is the CEO with mobilize. So I think you see we've got kind of a broad range of people that I think are in a position to help us working within the academic community to work more effectively. But before I jump into that, I think one of the distinguishing characteristics of this group, people ask, how are you organized? What are your purposes? I think one of our purposes, as I said, is to bring the academic community more as a community into this broader discussion about internet policy issues. And so we formed an academic advisory council. We're very, very pleased to say that Prof. Professor Marai, who's the dean of our School of Environmental and Information Studies at Keio University, has agreed to serve as the chairman. And we have a very, very representative board of scholars drawn from throughout the region. I'm happy, I was talking to Professor Shane Lee this afternoon. He's agreed to join us. We're also having Professor Hong Xu from Beijing Normal University. She's a professor in the School of Law there. From Japan, we are looking to have Professor Toshio Hobi from Waseda University, Professor Makoto Yokozawa from Kyoto University. These names, I think, are well known to many of you. Of course, our great friend, Professor Hiroshi Ezaki, who's with the Internet Society in Japan, but also a long-term friend of Keio University. And Tilman Chun. I saw Board of Trustees. So we're trying to bring in not just strong, very, very strong academic talent, but academic talent that is involved and engaged in the broader policy debate. Tilman Chun, who is not with us, but is a bona fide, as you know, internet pioneer, has agreed to be with us. Noyan Park, Professor of School of Law at Korea University. Abu Bakar Munir, who is a professor of the School of Law at the University of Malaya. Yudo Kini Sukayo, a computer scientist at the University of Indonesia. Woodrow Ha Parsog, who is an associate professor at the Cumberland School of Law at the Sanford University in the United States. And Richard Basher, who is the director of the U.S. Asia Technology Management Center at Stanford University. I think what we're trying to do is pull together both sides of the Asia Pacific. Universities on the west coast of the United States. We've got obviously the key universities in Northeast Asia and a very representative group in Southeast Asia. We hope to expand into India. And we hope to kind of work together to bring to bear legal, social, political, economic analysis to struggling with some of these problems that the engineers have been working on a long time, but frankly, it's sort of out of the bottle and out of the laboratory and into the wild. We find a way to work in that very, very new and difficult environment. So, very delighted to announce that we're doing this. We'll shortly have a website up. We'll be contacting all of you about some of our activities. But I'd like to turn the mic briefly over to my colleagues on the board, and then maybe conclude by asking Jun just to say a few quick remarks. So, Kato-san?
Thank you, Jim. First of all, I'd like to congratulate Jim Omiya and Keio University for launching this great initiative really called, pronounce it APIDE, APIDE. This is something really and interesting for all of us. We had this afternoon from 5 years of the internet, and we had many stories about great internet. But at the same time, I felt that this is just the beginning of the internet. In the future, in 100 years, 200 years, everybody will be dependent on this great creation of internet. And we have to make that happen. And we are all responsible for even doing so. So it's not just a history, this is the beginning. And I'm very glad that we can announce this great beginning of new initiative. Is deepened by the internet. This is, I think, a think tank, as Jim said. Think tank concept is not easy to understand in many parts of the world, especially in this part of the world. In Japan, not many think tanks are actually existing. And if they exist, they are sometimes sponsored by the government or sometimes sponsored by some specific companies and so on. This is a unique. Based on academics, having a neutral relationship with everybody. That means we have to work with everybody. This is the real participate of the mission. I was asked to join this group of board by Jim earlier this year, and he said, maybe Kato-san, you have to spend one time or two times at most. Kind of I don't know if that's true. I'm very glad to be a part of this great initiative. I can be in this room with all great colleagues, the board members going to be in the real world. We don't have to do many practical works and applications of the organization and so on. And we also need your help on launching this really nicely. Once again, thank you very much for the opportunity.
We are seeing new challenges that we are expecting that like 50 billion devices will be connected to the internet in a few years. But at the same time, I'm seeing that not only the business community, but also the academic community and the others are a little bit reluctant in changing things. So we need to find some ways so that we can accommodate these 50 billion devices. And at the same time, we need to accommodate the challenges from privacy issues and also the security issues, which are not a simple network issues anymore. And I'm very delighted to work from the business side and also from the network side to this new challenge. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you very much, Jim, and fellow board members. I think I'd just note that Jim mentioned earlier in the evening that the center of gravity was shifting for the internet to Asia. And if I could amend that thought just a little bit, it seems to me it's shifting perhaps from the more Atlantic focus that it once had decisively toward, certainly in terms of numbers and perhaps technology as well, to the Asia Pacific. So I'm particularly delighted to have this opportunity to work with Jim and Amir and the other members of the board in helping get this new foundation, this new think tank off the ground. Thank you very much.
Thank you. My name is Nako Mizukoshi. I'm a Japanese lawyer and mainly advise to high-tech companies in working on public policy as well. And this is the perfect day to start with them. And congratulations for Jim O'Meara and Keio Universities and other folks. And we learned great efforts and motivation to connect people this afternoon. And now, not only people but devices, many things are connecting each other. And we will see more opportunities, but we will see more issues. With a complicated society. However, we are very delighted to work with you and more connection and collaboration will be fruitful. I look forward to working with you. Thank you.
Jim, can I ask you just to say a quick word?
All right. Well, I was going to say, congratulations.
I think the thing is that 4 years ago, my plan after I left
Microsoft was to retire to Nagano. And I was very successful in building a house and living there until Professor Murai and Professor Kokuryo invited me down to Keio. And 4 years later, this is where we are.
Yeah.
And you need to take responsibility.
Alright. Okay, yeah, that's it. I take all the responsibility. Thank you very much. And I really appreciate that when Jim and Benny, he's a very powerful person in the organizing like this. And he's been staying in the university, having his own laboratory, and working with the students that those are his students, and then very, very actively organizing this kind of work in the building. Although he came from the, you know, I've been knowing him for a long time, and the US side, the Japan side, and the, you know, the policy and the technology and the technology international relationship and the building. What I found out is that, you know, I've been spending a lot of time these days dealing with the policy side as well, and I'm still working on it, you know, taking outside as well. But then I found out that it's a hard work, very hard work, like the developing of the, each of the precise technology, building, working, testing, and then convincing the users. You know, that's a kind of development of the, all the technology work that I've been involved. But the, you know, the working on a kind of policy side, think tank type of work, and then the business economy, talking with the government, changing the regulation, improving the regulation, or crashing the regulation, or whatever. This is very, very hard work. So please, I mean, anybody joining this thing, and then I really appreciate your efforts, and this is very important for our future. And then, as I mentioned in the, this afternoon, this is a very important. I talked about that, you know, technology is a perfect, I mean, data social safety. And, you know, I didn't say that. So it's really important that the requirements and the, to the technology, the complaints, issues, to be explicitly, clearly defined. This is very important to include the technology for the future. So now, this is like two wheels, right? Both wheels. And so the technology development is going to go on. And then also that now we have this type of a group to view the entire society, global society, and especially focusing on Asia Pacific and the contribution from Asia Pacific. That's what I've been working on. So I really am happy. But be careful. This is a very, very hard work. So I really appreciate that all the commitment you gave in this room for doing this. I really appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Good, thank you very much. And you know, the hard work portion I was well aware of, so I was very careful as I put this thing together to bring in someone who can do all the hard work. And frankly, Omer and I have been working together for four years now. He originally was a graduate student of mine at on the SFC campus, and after he graduated, we talked about him coming on and helping to begin work in the context of a research group at KO to evolve, hopefully, over time into something. And I really had no intention of moving beyond being a research group to actually organizing an institute. And this is a qualitatively different type of enterprise. One thing, we were going to be legally registered. There's a lot of things that go around with that, including formally organizing a board, really involving people in a very significant way in our operations. But this guy, about 3.5 years ago, walked into my office at KO, and he had a big piece of paper, and he said, "This is going to be our plan." He put down about 10 items, and down about item number 8 was create a think tank in Tokyo. And you have to remember, at this point, we didn't even have a website. So I wasn't sure how we were going to get to a think tank, and I won't even tell you where he wants to go beyond that, but I am going to turn it over briefly to Omer, because we would not be here today without a lot of his hard work. He's a guy that unusually combines an ability to work very, very hard, highly organized, but with very, very well developed policy senses and a solid grasp of the technology. You don't find a lot of people on that like that on the street corner. But as I look across this audience at the young people, if you want to work with us, if you want to be challenged, please walk through the door, because this is an organization for young people. It's the future.
Easiest way to sum up what this is and what it has been for the last 4 years is
represent today. It's difficult for young people to take risks within certain environments, but it's something that's needed. And when I walked into gym, I basically proposed a list of 10 risky things to do. And if it happened, then I would have other things to do, just to keep on moving. It wasn't a bad thing to fail. So I look forward to coming back to you guys in a year with results for us. Hopefully they are good. Some of them may be bad, but let's see where we can go. So I'm pleased to work with all of you, and I hope that we can continue to move forward. Thanks so much.
We're going to do a group photograph. I really would like everybody to participate in this. Who knows? 10, 15 years from now, you may be part of our program. Before that, I'm going to just briefly give Professor Farber the final word.
Word. Guys, I thoroughly enjoyed being here. I have fond memories of Japan and hopefully fond memories of the future that you guys can achieve. Just a side issue, I probably would have called it the Asian Pacific Institute for the Digital Society. Economy is a rather narrow thing that we've been playing with an East Coast version of that, and the impact of digitalization society is very, very complicated, and it's not being studied adequately, so I wish you all success.